What if I were to suggest that you play a key role in the awakening world? And that you are watching this because you have heard the call. We can start right now by opening our hearts and minds. Welcome to the awakening world.
Welcome everybody to the Awakening World, and it's Earth Day weekend, 2022. Again, a big hello to all of our friends that are already in our Zoom room. And I wanna thank all of you who are watching on Facebook. We've got a lot of friends watching on Facebook, and always let us know where you're coming from geographically. A big thanks, especially to those of you watching on Unify. We get thousands of views on Unify. And it's always exciting that we've got people from all over the world. So let us know. I know last night I noticed from Unify, we had people from Albania, Switzerland, South America, Australia, New Zealand, and of course, all throughout North America. So definitely let us know where you're from. And also, we're gonna have a lot of interaction tonight. We've got some really wonderful presenters, and we're gonna take some questions. And it's easiest if you come on into the Zoom room to talk with us. And it's easy to do that. Just go to globalpeacetribe.com, globalpeacetribe.com, and register. You'll get the links to all of our shows from now until the end of June. And we do three shows every weekend. We do Friday night, Saturday night, and Sunday morning. Always taking a topic and exploring it. And of course, this weekend's topic is all about Earth Day. And later today, you'll hear about, or tonight, you'll hear about what we're going to be doing tomorrow, Sunday. We've got great guests also planned for tomorrow. I want to also thank John and Summer Raymer from the Sign Network. They helped get us out to over 100 Facebook groups and pages. So that's wonderful. A lot of you are watching us that way right now. Also, a big hello to Alan Steinfeld and his YouTube channel, which also is a way that a lot of people watch us. So welcome wherever you are. Finally, I want to welcome people watching the recording. Our statistics show us that about 40% of the people who will end up hearing my voice right will be actually watching the recording. So wherever you are, whenever you're hearing this, welcome. So Earth Day 2022, what does that mean to you? That's a question that we're going to be asking our presenters throughout the evening and again tomorrow. And what are practical solutions? I think probably most of us are aware of how bad things are. And if you're not, you're probably going to get a few reminders tonight. But we want to primarily focus on what can we do? What are the little things we can do? And what are the big things that people like John Quigley are doing? You're going to meet John tonight. So we really want to celebrate choices that people are making to make a difference on our planet. And we've got a really wonderful show. And as always, on Saturday nights, we always have music. And our music tonight are two really special souls. Tatiana has come back. And this is Tatiana Speed. I had the joy of Tatiana being on another show that I did earlier this afternoon, a fundraising event for Ukraine. And so Tatiana's going to play live, and she's also going to provide us with one of her wonderful videos. Welcome back, Tatiana. It's good to have you with us.
Thank you. It's fun to see you so many times in one day, Scott.
I know. I'm
really wonderful.
Yeah, it's great. So thank you, Tatiana, for being with us. And also one of my dear friends, someone I love very much, and you met her last night, those of you who were with us Friday night, Destiny Love, coming all the way from Hawaii. And Destiny really is a living example of our future. She and her husband and two children are living very simply, very sustainably on the land. But luckily, they still have a little bit of technology, enough to provide some beautiful music. So Destiny, thank you also for being with us again tonight.
Thank you. Thanks so much, Scott and everybody.
I'm going to wait to introduce the Sue and all of those people, because that's about to happen. But again, I want to introduce Robin Streichler, who has really helped to put tonight's show together. And really, a very big highlight of the show is going to be Robin has written a screenplay, and we are going to have an experience of that screenplay. She pulled together a number of professional actors, and they did a reading, and it's going to be a really powerful 30-minute video reading, but most of the actors are going to be with us, and they're going to have a conversation, and it's an environmental screenplay. And Robin, tell us just briefly a little bit about the screenplay.
Well, the screenplay is about, you know, I know that Don't Look Up, and everyone probably knows that, and that's another comet hits the earth type thing, and it doesn't have a good ending. But my screenplay is sort of Don't Look Up meets Airplane. So not only do we have a wild ride and some levity through the ride, and we have another disaster catalyst, which is a solar flare affecting our Earth because we don't have the, you know, atmosphere anymore to protect it. And mainly what's different about my apocalyptic rom-com is that it has a positive vision for the future. And that's what I want to bring through my work. And that's what we need to see more of. And it doesn't have any violence or anything, but I think it would be very appealing to mainstream audiences. So I welcome you all to come tonight. It is truly a wild ride, and we had a lot of fun putting it together.
Beautiful. Thank you, Robin. We're also going to hear tonight from John Quigley. And many of you are probably familiar with him. He's an award-winning artist, producer, and activist. And he's the founder of Spectral Q. It's a unique mix of human installation and aerial photography. And it helps us to really see the big picture, if you will, and bring together communities to create large-scale messages for the common good. He's also the director of Artists for Amazonia, a very important campaign, harnessing this creative and entertainment influencers to catalyze the global action necessary to the crisis in the Amazon rainforest. So, John, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you, Scott. It's a pleasure to be here. And I just want to acknowledge you and Robin and Debbie. And this is just such a beautiful burst of positivity in what seems like a sea of darkness we've been swimming in recently. So I just want to acknowledge you. It's so important to continue to put out that light. And for me, Earth Day is very special. I've done a lot of work on Earth Day over the years, so it's a special time to renew our commitment to the Earth. First, just the awareness that we all come from the Earth, and then hopefully we're all taking some kind of action to bring our out-of-whack systems into line with, you know, the natural rhythm that we need to move forward. So it's a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, thank you, John. Looking forward to seeing your artwork and learning more about the great work you're doing. We also, a little bit later on in the show, are going to hear from Catherine Woodward Thomas. She is a best-selling author. And also, I discovered a wonderful actress, as you're about to experience a little bit later during our after show. She's got quite the chops. So, Catherine, really happy to have you with us, and we'll be hearing from you shortly.
Thank you. Looking forward to it.
And one of my absolute favorite voices, Claire Dubois, did a pre-record for us, and she is a powerhouse. And also Brooke Medicine Eagle is going to join us live. So that's what we've got planned for tonight. And ours is some special surprises, perhaps. So to move us forward, I'm going to turn it over to Robin, because she's put together a really cool way to start our show. So Robin, tell us what you've got.
What I've got is three very special people. I have David Benjamin, and he created with a co-creator a book called Pacha's Pajamas. And it's a, and there's a videos and all sorts of wonderful media to reach out to children all over the world to bring them into the fold of oneness with each other. That's so touching and beautiful about the video we're gonna see. And to care for the earth together, to work together to care for the earth. So this is David. And then David's going to be joined by Sue Blythe, who is working on the Climate Collaboratory, also with children and others, to bring our climate stories together and to do many, many creative things along with David and Pacha's Pajamas to spread the word and get our stories about what we're all going through together and how we can work together to protect our planet. And a very special guest is with us, with the two of them, is Adrian Alvarez, who actually, he's 14 years old, he's an environmental activist already, and he went to the UN on during the peace, is what they call the Week of Peace, or I'm sorry, I don't remember the name of it, but he went there and he spoke, he was a speaker, and he's going to share with us how he's working with Sue and David to reach out and be a spokesperson actually for the children. So we're gonna start now, and I'm gonna turn it over to David to introduce the Pacha's Pajamas video.
All right, well, thanks Robin. My name is David Benjamin, and I've been working with this Pacha's Pajamas story for about 11 years. Now it seems like such a long time. It's funny because I've heard people say it takes about a decade for an overnight success. So I suppose it's still possible for us. This video that you're about to watch right now was created, I believe, in 2014. It was the first animated video that we did for Pacha's Pajamas. And I think the main thing to know is that Pacha's a little girl with big dreams. Her dreams are bigger than the Andes Mountains, which are the homeland of her ancestors. And when she goes to sleep, whatever's on her pajamas becomes her dream world.
All right, let's take a look. It's a wonderful video, everybody. I think you can enjoy it very, very much.
Good morning, Pacha.
What about a global dance party that brings us all together? Imagine everyone across the world dancing and singing, "We are all connected."
Sounds like something the world really needs right now.
Yeah, let's do a video.
Whoa, 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 we are all connected. Whoa, whoa, whoa. We are all connected.
Yeah. Connected like a magnet, these cameras so candid, embrace your day. turned to a ballad hit. Everybody saving it, many parties saving it. Imagine this nation grip, like the way flowers pick. Picture us all in the sunset, across the earth shine oneness. Life is togetherness. Whoa, whoa, whoa. A message crammed in a bottle of sand, right. A buck of dough, a wingo, a clam. Make shots of birth, babies take trends. Cross oceans, deserts, land in hip hop. Problem us as we stand as one. Part of me is part of you. You can't never be apart from the same jam. Connected like artists to the fans. A cat's cake walk or a ghost blind by end. It's the last that comes first again. Blast up the drum, sky to the land. After the young see the ocean dance. Creator to the creations. With the tides flying like ding ones, the fire. Dreams of ice and cream.
Well, that's Pacha's Pajamas, Do the Connected Dance, our first video from way back when, like I said,
it would be awesome if you did a video with your friends.
Whoops.
Let's learn the routine. It's easy. You just need to learn the choreography for the chorus. We'll dance freestyle during the rap sections.
I think I missed a stop too early.
Let's start with the footwork.
All right. Well, thanks so much for inviting me here, and Sue and Adrian for joining me as well. When developing something like Pacha, we started with the message. We knew that we wanted to communicate something differently than what was already out there in the world. And we came up with the inquiry, well, what would nature say if it could talk directly to today's kids? What would nature want kids to know? We thought a while about this, and this is me and Aaron Abelman. He actually had authored a story called Pachamama's Pajamas, which was about a bunch of animals coming together in the jungle. They end up having this amazing festival, and the second to last page of that book, a little girl named Pacha popped up in her pajamas, and it turned out it was her dream the whole way. But we had that as a foundation, but we still stepped back and said, well, what would nature want to say to today's kids? And what we came up with was we needed to translate the ancient knowledge and ways of thinking about our relationships with one another, with ourselves, and with nature into the language of today's kids. And that means a great story, music, dance, video, technology. These are all things that today's kids are into. And so we strove from the very beginning to create this multimedia story world about a little girl named Pacha who, like I said, has big dreams. And when she goes to sleep, the jaguar, the whale, the hummingbird, the pebble, the tree, and the mushroom, they all come together with her to throw the greatest festival in the history of the planet. But no humans were invited. The animals all thought that she's a little gorilla because she's wearing a gorilla mask. They end up throwing this festival called Pachajama. 7 days and seven nights, where all the animals are coming together, and they're doing many different types of performances, rap battles and open mics, music, song, dance, speeches, spoken word. They're doing it all, and it's all really in the name of coming together and trying to come to solutions for what's happening, the things that were happening with their home. And at the end of the festival, Pacha, she does this amazing dance sequence. And halfway through it, she throws off her mask. It's because she can't bear not being herself. And the whole stadium goes quiet. She hears voices. It's a human, it's a human, it's a human. And then she says, I'm not just human. I'm a child of nature too. Your dream is my dream too. When I've been here in this dream, I learned that we are all connected, and I'm going to bring that message to the waking world. So when she wakes up, Pacha wants to bring this this message. We are all connected to the world. And I want to mention this was a collaboration of me and Aaron beginning, but we brought in Dre Johnson as our music supervisor, and then we brought in Ala L. Henson to do the animation, the music that Dre and Aaron and I helped kind of supervise. We created that as the basis for the animation. Ala came on top of that, did the animation, and then we used those animations to create an augmented reality book. And now 3 or 4 years later, after our initial book came out, we have 2 additional books, and we are bringing this into the Web3 world with NFTs and NFT metaverse game. And we wanna do a free mint. Basically, it's a giving away 10,000 free NFT books for the Pacha's younger books.
Fabulous. So, David, thank you so much. I'm going to take people to the website where you can track all the amazing things that they're doing. And it's pachaverse.io, P-A-C-H-A, Pachaverse, like universe, V-E-R-S-E.io. And as you can tell, Javed is a very beautiful, ambitious guy with a lot going on. You can catch snippets of the videos here. You can learn all about Animal Idol 2022. That looks pretty cool, kind of what he talked about. And there's a lot going on. So we definitely we'll stay in touch with what you're doing, Javed. I do want to give a couple minutes to Sue and Adrian to talk about the work you're doing and how this has inspired you and where you've gone with the Pachaverse and helping to engage young people.
Well, I'm Sue Blythe. I was on the other side of the country from David, and I had been since the year 2000 trying to make a story and a community engagement program based on the Earth Charter. And when I came across Pacha's pajamas, I thought, oh my gosh, there it is. That's the story I want. And so I asked David, I would like to make a sequel to this, and I want to bring the humans in and share some of the exciting things that I know were going on in Florida, where I've been working with a program out of the University of Florida Extension. And so we're trying to make an intergenerational program based on the Earth Charter. And I tuned in, and I knew we needed some children. We really didn't have any children yet. And so I tuned in on the 20th anniversary of the Earth Charter. There was a global call, and the last speakers on this global call were my new friends, Adrian and his sister, Rebecca. And Adrian, maybe you could tell us a little bit about how you got to that global call and some of the things you're working on since.
Well, first off, hello, everyone. I'm Adrian Alvarez. I hope you all are having a great evening wherever you are. Well, my journey really started when I was little, really. My parents taught me and my two sisters how to take care of everything around us, from our clothes, our house, to the animals, nature, and the plants. And one way that they taught us this is by creating a little fun activity, which was to take care of monarch butterflies. Because down here in Florida, we get a lot of monarch butterflies, and they are endangered because we keep cutting down their habitats. So we decided to make a video on how to take care of monarch butterflies, and this eventually reached the Earth Charter International. So as time went by, they asked me and my sisters and my family to make videos on the four pillars of the Earth Charter to explain to both children and adults what they mean. And then I got invited to the 2020 Turning Consciousness into Action in an Interdependent World. I got invited to that event, and that's what Sue was talking about. That's where I ended up speaking with my sister Rebecca, and that's how I got in touch with Sue. And after that, Sue has been teaching me a lot of things and has helped me get in touch with many people to try to spread my word and the voice of us children to try to get more children involved, because I feel like us children can help too.
Absolutely. You know, thank you so much, Adrian. And you are representing such a large population for all of us to really take into consideration as we are in this Earth Day weekend. We need to do a better job of creating a healthy world for you and all the young people you represent to be able to live in. And we have a lot of work to do to clean up a mess that some of us that are older have made, that you're inheriting. So thank you for your dedication, and thank you for joining us tonight. You're a wonderful speaker, and you're very inspirational, very inspiring. And Sue, thank you for the way that you're nurturing these young people along and inspiring them. And for more information on what Sue's doing, go to Gardens of Global Unity. What a wonderful name that is. Gardens of Global Unity /climate-collaboratory. And our dear Debbie Johnston is putting that into the chat box. And that's where you can learn all about what they're doing and keep track. And so tell us a little bit about this, building community in a changing climate. What is that, and how do people interact?
Okay, well, this is our interfaith work that we're doing really on a statewide level. I'm focusing right now on Alachua County, Florida, the Gainesville area, University of Florida. And we are engaging the community. Adrian and his sisters made a little video, 2-minute invitation video, to help build a world house based on Martin Luther King's vision of a world where we can all learn to live together in peace. And we have a lot of work. We're working now with the Star Center Theater, putting together a musical play. And we hope that within a year, we're going to have something wonderful, and people will say, oh, it's one of those overnight successes, right? That's our dream. And as David says, it can take a while for that to happen. But
however
we're doing
it. It takes for that overnight success.
Yeah. So we will definitely
continue to track you and the work that you're doing, and certainly hope to have you and David and Adrian back as you come up with these other creative expressions.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you. It's great to meet you. God's blessings. Adrian, thank you, partner. I so appreciate the work you're doing. And really, you are an inspiration for all of us. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you so much, Scott, for having me on this show. And well, thank you for the kind words.
Absolutely. Well, we're going to keep track of you. You're going to be back on the show with next time we'll take a look at your video, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Great. Thanks. Let's just take a breath and appreciate. Maybe think of the children you know in your life, whether they're your own children or your grandchildren or children of friends. I mean, we really got, this is why we have to do a better job of delivering a healthier, more sustainable planet to Adrian and the millions of children he represents. Well, that's a tough act to follow. They say you never want to follow an act, with children. But luckily, we have Tatiana Speed with us, and she's pretty remarkable. Tatiana, thank you so much for being with us. And I know you've got a special song for us, so it's all yours.
Thank you, Scott. And wow, so honored to be here with these incredible speakers and all the wonderful work that they are doing for the world. So thank you so much for that. And I want to share a song. The song is called Ignite, and it is kind of my call to action to myself, to anyone else, and kind of my imagining what it would be like if every single person in the world was tapped in to their own purpose, power, light, and how we could ignite and catalyze each other to create the shift in the world that is so needed. And I see many examples of that on this call today. So this song is dedicated to all of you, and it is called Ignite. The world is changing, the world's on fire. I want to do my part to inspire change. I wanna make my home a sanctuary of love and peace and harmony, and be the change I wanna see. The earth is my home, the earth is my mother. We will never have any other to help renew, rebuild, rebirth, a new way to be. Ignite, catalyze, take flight, burn like the sun, dispelling the night. Help humanity find its way back home. I wanna unite, stand and rise, shine bright, bring the truth into the light. Help humanity find its way back home. Sing, come and pray, come and bring all you are and all you love. A new day is dawning. I feel it calling us to help rebirth a new way to be on earth. I wanna ignite, catalyze, take flight, burn like the sun, dispelling the night. Help humanity find its way back home. I wanna unite, stand and rise, shine bright, bring the truth into the light. Help humanity find its way back home. Let's find our way back home. Let's find my part to inspire change. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you so much, Tatiana. You ended a little bit quicker than I was ready for you, so I'm off there for a minute. Whoops, I'm actually trying to put the, there we go. Tatiana, I really want to thank you. You sing with so much heart and so much love, but your words are also really right there, right direct. And how are you doing with watching climate change? How does the impact of climate change, what's going on in our world, how does that impact you? And how do you deal with some of the sad and hard parts of it?
I'm just going to take these things off my voice. Can you hear me now? Okay, there we go. Yeah, thank you for that question, Scott. I think like so many of us, there's a combination of frustration, helplessness, grief. This last summer that passed, my home was not my home, but all around me was in flames. There was massive fires. And for 2 months, we couldn't breathe the air or go outside during the summer. So
I feel like climate change is really knocking on our door now. There's no more denying it. And even my grandfather, who I've had trouble with at times explaining that climate change is real, actually was coming, you know, recognizing what was happening. And yeah, I think it's a process of being with the emotions of frustration and helplessness and then doing the small parts that we can do. I try to make a change with music and the activism that I do, and just knowing that so many of us around the world are walking together this path that's shifting consciousness, and having trust and faith that that's going to make the change we need.
Yeah. Thank you. You know, I want to acknowledge that between you and Adrian and myself, we've got three different generations. And so just as I'm going to bring Adrian on for a moment, Adrian too. And here we are, you know, here are three different generations, and we all want the same thing. We all have to find the ways to contribute. So thank you, Adrian, for how you're contributing. Thank you, Tatiana, for how you're contributing. And both of you are really inspiring and have gotten us off to a wonderful start. And a reminder that for people to get more of Tatiana, a couple things. Please go to her website. It's her name, TatianaSpeed.com. And always, you know, when I give you people, people's websites, always give them their name and email address so that they can, you know, let you know about albums and things. And also, she's on Instagram. So definitely, she's the only Tatiana Speed on Instagram. I just checked. So definitely, follow her on Instagram, buy her albums, buy her music. And Tatiana, you're going to introduce your video for us a little bit later on tonight?
Absolutely. Looking forward to it.
Great. Thanks for staying with us. We'll see you in a little bit then. All right. I get to introduce our next presenter. And actually, this is one of those cases where I knew of her long before I met her. This is Catherine Woodward Thomas. And I was very familiar with both of her books, Conscious Uncoupling and Calling in the One. And she is going to be on a show we're doing in a couple months. In June, we're going to do a show called Authors That We Love. And that includes Catherine Woodward Thomas, as well as Andrew Harvey and Carolyn Meese and some of the other authors that we love on this show. But today, she's here to talk about what Earth Day means to her. So, Catherine, thank you for being with us.
Oh, it's such a joy. I'm so moved by this show. I'm like all teary. Tatiana made me cry. Adrian made me cry. I'm hoping I can speak because I'm so touched. And isn't it perfect that the sun is like beaming on me strongly so I can barely see. So we love nature, and my cat might start screaming in the background. So I'm like, okay, well, the more nature, the merrier. And Scott, thank you for hosting this. This is a really important conversation. I know that so many of us are feeling frustrated, like Tatiana said, and so overwhelmed. And it's really touching my heart how many things people are doing that everyone's sharing in the chat. I don't know if you guys have been kind of looking at all the things that we're doing, sensitive beings that we are, you know, but Dr. Laura does not own a car. Carolyn teaches climate science. Destiny and her family are living sustainably on the land. Wild Abbot Jerry is spending 12 to 20 hours a week in nature. Jeff converted 95% of his lawn to a garden. Robin wrote this brilliant screenplay that we're going to be, you and I have the privilege of being a part of later on. And then Adrienne, your film about monarch butterflies. So there's a lot of beauty and goodness that's happening. And I'm really grateful to be in the inquiry together, because I know that so many of us are doing our best to stay present to the news, no matter how difficult it is to read the newspaper, that we're turning towards it, we're witnessing, we're staying with our own experience of grief and all of the many feelings that we have. And at the same time, we're active, we're giving things up. We are, you know, riding bikes or using public transportation. We're eating less meat. We're committing to causes. We're giving what we can. And And that's how we are individually rising and just being generative in the face of all of the breakdowns. And I think, you know, it is no secret, obviously, the cat's out of the bag that we are living in very dark times, and it is pushing on us to rise in our light. It's pushing on us to be braver, to be more vocal, to be more visible. In Conscious Uncoupling, I wrote, with all the darkness we may be walking through, it's good to remember that where there is no light, we have the choice to become it. So that's what's happening for our tribe. In the face of greed, we are generating generosity and kindness. And in the face of corruption, we are standing as never before for justice, for goodness, for truth. In the face of indifference, in the face of suffering, we generate love. In the face of abuse, we are standing for that which is right and wholesome and good. Author Valerie Kerr, who wrote the bestseller See No Stranger, once said, "The future is dark, but what if the darkness is not of the tomb, but of a womb?" And so we're listening for that which is wanting to be born. And this is the culture, this is the consciousness that I'm just hearing all of us cultivating, each in our own unique way. Sometimes they're small gestures, sometimes they're grand gestures. But all of us are starting to up-level our willingness, not only to sacrifice, but to be generative of the world that we want to live in the face of escalating evidence to the contrary. But I want to read a beautiful passageway to you that Llewellyn von Lee wrote. Llewellyn is a Sufi mystic. And this is one of my favorite passages that I want to share tonight. He says, "A web of light has been created around the world to help us make this transition. Through this web, the invisible is already becoming visible. The signs of God already revealing themselves in a new way. But love needs us to bring this potential into manifestation." And that's my kitty, if you hear that in the background. She's just singing. She's very happy. "But love needs us to bring this potential into manifestation, to make it part of the fabric of daily life. Without our participation, the potential will ebb into a fading promise of something that might have happened. If that light can be brought into consciousness, then it can travel through the web of connections, awakening centers of consciousness within all of humanity. Humanity will have access to the wisdom, power, and love that it needs to take the next step in its spiritual evolution, to learn to function in oneness as a dynamic, interrelated whole. Without this awakening, patterns of energy flow around the planet will remain dormant or function on a lower level. And once again, humanity will have missed an opportunity." So I think we're all sensing the criticalness of this. And I think that all of us are hearing this invitation. And I can just speak for all of us that we're all a yes to it. You know, I think we recognize the difference between praying for a world of goodness and love to leave to our children, or actually making the decision to become the source of that love and goodness. And so it might seem counterintuitive for some of us to start to give at this level to the world, to expand our identity beyond our own personal happiness, and to begin to vision for the world. So as we're visioning for personal transformation, we're visioning for transformation of the world. And we're counteracting the dystopian images that Hollywood has been feeding us. And we're actively cultivating, what does it look like when the world works for everyone? When we are living in harmony with the earth, in harmony with the cycles of nature, in harmony with each other. I think that the secret to realizing abundance for ourselves is to become the source of it for others. And at this point in our journey, we recognize that the goal of personal development is not just self-actualization, but self-transcendence. You know, a lot of us are familiar with Abraham Maslow's hierarchy of needs, and the highest need that we had, once you had all your survival and your belonging taken care of, the kind of day-to-day physical needs, was self-actualization. But before he died, he added self-transcendence. And basically what he said before he died is, you know, I was wrong. It's not just about us becoming all that we can be. We need to actually rise and become who we are for others. So all of us here, we're in those waters, and we're really trying on being ambitious, not just for ourselves, but we are ambitious for the world. We're ambitious for the human race, and we are expanding our sense of self to include who we are for the whole. So I just want to kind of end with a visioning prayer for all of us to begin to step into this recognition of who we really are for the world. Some of us are overly identified with the small self that we created in response to old hurts, old wounds, old traumas, but it's not who we are. And we don't really have time to be living from that small version of ourselves any longer. The world needs us, God needs us, to actually begin living from the largeness of who we came here to be for the world. So let's just close our eyes for a moment. And I just invite you to take a deep breath as though you could breathe all the way down into your hips. And just moving into this place of deep listening and receptivity, allowing yourself to feel held by this force and field of life that is up underneath you and supporting you and guiding you. Recognizing that you were born for this, that you came here for this mighty purpose, that your soul chose to incarnate right now, to be on planet Earth, to become a bringer of light, a bringer of hope, and a bringer of love. And just asking the universe, asking your soul, what offerings am I here to make? What is my contribution to healing, to evolution, to the awakening of love? And just allowing yourself to really own that this is indeed who you are. Expanding beyond the smallness of your egoic self that you might have created in response to being born somehow into a family that couldn't hold your brightness, your brilliance, your sensitivity, your wild creativity. And if you've been identified with that part of yourself, just letting it go now, sending love to that part of you, recognizing it's not even personal to you. And remind yourself of the truth of who you came here to be, an expression of love, generosity, healing, and grace. You are a force of nature here to transform the world in unique and beautiful ways. Thank you so much. So it is, so it shall be.
Catherine, thank you so, so much. I'm so appreciating your wisdom. And I want to give Destiny a heads up. We're going to have you play next, Destiny. We were going to actually play a prayer from Grandmother Flor de Mayo, but since you just led us in such a beautiful prayer, I'm going to do the Grandmother Flor de Mayo prayer later on in the show. Thank you. Thank you for reminding us of who we are and what we're capable of being. Thank you for reminding us that the more that we are generous, the more that that creates the ripple that we need to create to get us out of the old paradigm of grasping and greed and survival, and to come into the new paradigm of thriving. For truly we are moving from survival to thriving. And you were so eloquent with that. And I, well, stay on camera for one more moment. I want to just read a little bit from Connie and Andrew. There's so many people that are saying, thank you, oh my God, this is amazing. But I do like to incorporate some of our listeners. And Connie and Andrew wrote, yes, Catherine, brilliant. There is a new energy available on the earth which supports the manifestation of the infinite balance, abundance, and unconditional love that are at the foundation of universal law. Individuals are beginning to experience these in their lives, which step by step influences all of us to make new choices on how we live day by day. So thank you, Connie and Andrew, and thank you, Catherine, for that beautiful inspiration. Thank you.
Thank you.
I do want to let people know about where you can find all things Catherine Woodward Thomas, and it's her website, and again, it's her name, CatherineWoodwardThomas.com. And do you want to share anything with us about your upcoming webinar trainings?
Oh, thank you, Scott. You know, there's, first of all, these two webinars that you see on the screen now at my website are free. And they're one we did last week, one we're doing this week. And it's really about you stepping into recognizing who you came here to be and what you came here to create and being able to live from that future backwards. A lot of us are doing our own inner work kind of from the past forward, where we're doing a lot of trauma work, a lot of healing, but we also want to look to the future. As I say, I like to say healing is the domain of the past, but transformation is the domain of the future. And when we really stand for a future that's kind of unprecedented, unpredictable, just living as a dream in our hearts, what happens when we set an intention for that future is we begin to be pulled by that vision into who we will need to become in order for it to manifest and sustain. So I'm really teaching people how to transform their lives rapidly, radically with this technology.
I want to do that. I want to take it. So I'm going to go back to the website just for a moment. So that, and it's free. What a gift. It's coming just in a couple days, Tuesday, April 26th. It's in the morning. It's at 9 o'clock Pacific time, 12 noon Eastern. I see Tatiana's getting out a pen and writing it down. And I think you're going to get some Global Peace Tribers there.
Oh, great. And it's recorded. So if you can't be there, it's an odd time for some people. They're just starting their work day, but we will send you the recording.
Beautiful. So again, CatherineWoodwardThomas.com. And then just at the very, very top and just click register now. And you know what's interesting? Oh, there we go. Okay, it is working. And so register, and that's beautiful that it's free. It's so important for us to listen to wisdom keepers like yourself who are helping us to learn how to create the future that we really want to create and not that apocalyptic wasteland story that we've seen over and over and over.
Can I tell you something about Margaret Atwood, who wrote The Handmaid's Tale, which is a brilliant show, but it's quite dystopian. She's now doing talks all over the country about and ignite your creativity for the positive possible future that we could all co-create together.
Oh,
isn't that beautiful? So
that is.
Yeah, that's the conversation. We need to turn our attention there. Thank you. Absolutely. Thank you for this beautiful, beautiful event. Thank you.
Absolutely. And remember, everybody, we're going to see Catherine's acting as part of our after show. And then she'll be back on our Authors That We Love weekend, which is June 9th, 10th, 11th. We've got Matt Kahn, Andrew Harvey, Carolyn Meese, and Catherine. So it's going to be a wonderful weekend. Thank you, Catherine.
Thank you.
So this is now my good friend, Destiny Love. And Destiny, I have a long friendship. We met in Louisville, Kentucky. I was teaching there, and she brought her mother and her grandmother. I remember I was all excited. It was the first time that I was teaching three generations at the same time. Mm-hmm. And I had the honor to officiate Destiny's wedding many years ago. She now has two children that she's raising in a very beautiful, sustainable way. Some of you who joined us last night already heard her, but I'm so glad that you're with us again tonight, Destiny. Mm-hmm. It's just beautiful to have you with us.
Wow, I'm so blown away. Catherine, that was so potent and beautiful. And just the message that I know I needed personally and so many of us here. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I can't wait for your music.
And Scott, thank you for having me. Wow, I feel so, so grateful to be here.
And by the way, we have exactly 111 participants in the Zoom room right now. So for all of you 111 people, I just happened to notice that. Okay, take it away, Destiny.
Change is turning to something new. I rest in the unknown, or I come unglued. Something's birthing so tender and true. I'm gentle now, I know we'll make it through. Unwinding high, I open wide, roots down deep, find my center inside. The river is flowing, flowing and growing. The river is flowing down the sea. Mother, carry me, child I will always be. Mother, carry me down the sea. My change is turning something new. I rest in the unknown, where I come unglued. Something's birthing so tender and true. I'm gentle now, I know I'll make it through. We will get. You will break off through. Unwinding high, I open wide, roots down deep, find my center inside. Unwinding high, I open wide, roots down deep, find my center inside. Mother goddess surrounds us, mother goddess.
Go to gallery view so we can see everybody twinkling, New Destiny. There's a purity that you've always had that comes through so beautifully in your music. You're just this incredible purity of spirit that's so beautiful. So beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah, I feel so much change is on the horizon. And us being together in this way is such a testament to that, right? That we are living the next steps. It's just so beautiful. And I know with certainty that our next generations are supported, that our ancestors are here holding us and supporting our children to learn the ways of the earth, to remember. It's not even learning, it's remembering. And, you know, I'm blessed having these two beautiful children and now raising them where we're living outdoors 95% of the time. And yeah, they're just so naturally attuned to nature, our little children. So just getting them outside as much as possible, this is a really powerful thing we can do as adults to support our little ones, get them unmasked and outside and playing.
Beautiful. Absolutely. Thank you so much for being such a model and such an inspiration for us. And you can, I just want to encourage everybody to support Destiny. She uses Linktree. I think most of you by now know about Linktree. It's linktr.ee. And then in her case, /DestinyLoveMusic. And you can get her music on Bandcamp, Spotify, iTunes. But she's also got books. And are you doing embodied voice healing work, Destiny?
Yeah, that's my main work. So that's my main website there up at the top.
Okay, and so if
it's been links into the Singing Spirit Alive work, the Song Church work, the ecstatic singing, and the full spectrum of voice reclamation, reclaiming the power of our singing, that it brings us back into our roots. It's our birthright to sing and dance. So that full spectrum of reclaiming the voice as a tool for healing the chakras, healing inside, healing those bound up tissues that can soften just with a certain of our voice, all the way to freestyle singing and songwriting and performance, prayer performance.
Well, thank you. And Destiny's going to be back with one more song a little bit later on tonight to close out the show, the main show. Destiny, thank you so much. You know,
thank
I love you,
you
very
so much.
Much. It's so good having you with us this weekend.
So good.
Well, as you probably all have observed by now, we're really focusing on how people are dealing with climate change and the environment through creative expression. And from music, we now go to another amazing human being and his creative expression. And this is John Quigley. And I've been aware of his artwork. So I was really excited when Robin said that she thought she could get John Quigley. I said, yes, please. Again, we're going to see examples of his work, but he has really combined bringing human beings together and in unique and creative ways. And he's a very important activist. So I'm not going to say too much more. I'm eager to hear John, what he wants to share with us about what he's done in the past and what he's doing in present time. John, welcome to the Awakening World.
Thank you so much, Scott. This has been an absolute gift for me to be present for this music, for the prayer from Catherine, from all the other speakers who have been offering their gifts. I just want to start talking a little bit about my involvement with Earth Day, just briefly. I started as a 10-year-old. I went to school one day and they had seedlings for us all in class. And they gave them out and I took it home and I planted it. And about, 8 years later, my mom took a picture of me having grown and the tree having grown to about 20, 25 feet tall. And there is something about that, that it really sort of taught me about the power of action. And I think for me, action has been kind of the defining quality of my work. Years later, Earth Day 1990, I became an organizer for that event in Los Angeles and did a lot of things related to Earth Day and then founded Earth Day Los Angeles. And one of the tactics we used along the way, it occurred in Earth Day 1994, is we had thousands of school kids on the beach, cleaning up the beach. And just a week before, I had the thought, well, what if we have them all spell out Clean Up LA and photograph it from the sky? So that's what happened. And it led to a whole new world for me of what I called aerial art at the time. And it's been called a few different things, living art, that sort of thing. And I'm gonna share my screen, but it took me around the world, and I was blessed to work in a variety of communities, advocating for issues where the communities didn't have the resources to compete with corporate advertising. It was sort of a whole series of communities, and let me just clear my space here a little bit. So this is an image some of you may have seen. This is from the COP21 climate talks in Paris in 2015. And what I love about this is, because of the terrorist bombing, this idea of 100% renewable energy also translates to the idea of that peace is renewable. And I think in this time right now, with what's going on in Ukraine and other parts of the world, it's important for us to remember that. So I'm gonna just, basically, I started doing these things where I used large crowds to embody messages for the common good. And these were aspirational. What do we want? Not, you know, I tried to focus on the positive. And I'm just gonna kind of skip through. This is in front of the Reichstag in Germany, where we did a mixed media with fabric. This is on the beach in Santa Monica before the Iraq War. This is in tribute to Martin Luther King in Memphis. This is in Rio. This is about advocating for the coral reefs off the coast of Belize, Australia, Bondi Beach. This is in San Francisco, Rise for Climate Justice. South Africa on Freedom Day, it was an interpretation of Nelson Mandela from a local indigenous artist, and the spirit of Ubuntu. In Manger Square in Israel, in Bethlehem on Christmas Eve, now more than ever, we need to remember this, you know, that it's really about love all, love wins. And this is one I'll focus on a little bit more. This is at the border between San Diego and Mexico. So on the right side of the frame are school kids from Mexico, and on the left side are school kids from the US. And there's a 200 yard gap because that was the rules for the US Immigration Service. But what I love about this is, after we did this image, the school kids didn't care about the rules, and they all came to say hi to each other, and they rushed the fence. It set off alarms, but they relaxed and allowed the kids to have an international experience of connection and communion. This is about the Keystone Pipeline Route, 80 acre crop art. There's a whole series on ice about climate change. It's a Da Vinci the size of a football field. I won't go into all of these. These are boats, the biggest 190, about ocean acidification. This is about offshore oil drilling in Portugal, which we won that campaign and drove the oil companies out. And to this day, the southern coast of Portugal, it's one of the great victories in the last few decades against big oil to keep those oil rigs off the southern coast. This is at Standing Rock, and I saw from Wild About Jerry, he was there filming that day. This is up in the Arctic National Wildlife Refuge. This is in Southern California. So this is what I want to get to, the main event here, which is what I'm working on now, which is about the Amazon, which to me is the first big domino in the climate story. And this was at the first puncture wound in Ecuador. This is the Yasuni, the most biologically diverse area of the entire Amazon. And these are other images on behalf of the Amazon with native leaders, warriors, including the great Sonia Guajajara and Chief Haoni, who is the most revered indigenous leader in the Amazon. And so I bring this up because the Amazon scientifically has reached a tipping point. And we are now at a point where we've got 3 years. Actually, we need to protect 80% of it by 2025 to keep it from collapsing ecologically and turning into a savanna eventually. What that would do is that would wreak havoc with global climate stability. And so we're working with indigenous leadership from across the Amazon. We created an organization called Artists for Amazonia to build a bridge to influencers in Hollywood and other parts of the entertainment industry to communicate what's going on. This was after the fire episode of 2019 that shocked the world. But to me, we have to save the Amazon. We have to keep it standing. And it's under grave threat right now. So those of you who want to take action, I'm going to post a couple other websites here. Amazon Watch is an incredible organization to get involved where you can actually take action. And again, all this beautiful creativity for Earth Day, it's so important because seeing the future we want, and I loved what Catherine was doing with her visualization, like we have to retain our sacred core and that beautiful vision for what the world could be. That is our job number one. And then the next job is taking action. Just take some small piece, whatever it is, whatever your contribution is. And you know, that is what is, you know, going to bring about, that is going to manifest the vision of the world we want to live in.
Wow. John, what you're doing is so important, and it's, how do you organize, especially in foreign countries, all those people to then create the design of the whale or whatever the message is? How do you make that happen?
That is still a little bit of a mystery to myself, Scott, but it's all about relationship, you know, and it's really about people. Once I started doing it for a while, people were reaching out to me, and there has to be trust involved. The community needs to trust that this is something that's going to help. And for a lot of communities, particularly indigenous communities, this is one way that they can become visible and their desires. And so, but it's usually I get brokered in through someone that they already trust. They show them my work, and then we start to work together, usually a creative collaboration, maybe working with one of their artists to come up with a design. But it's all about relationships. Mm-hmm. And this, in this fragmented world today, retaining that openness to human connection, I think is so crucial for our future. And to achieve all of these images, that was central to all of it. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, what I love about it is it's a microcosm of what the macrocosm needs to do. That all those individuals are willing to get out of their own ego and all form the image of the whale or the image of Martin Luther King or whatever it is. And so it's this beautiful example of collaboration to create something far greater than what any one individual could do. Mm-hmm. And obviously that's what we need, you know, that's a microcosm example of what we need to be able to do as humanity. So it's extremely inspiring, very, very powerful.
Thank you. I'd like to just add one little splash of magic.
Yeah. So
you talked about this. There's a moment in all of these where the many become one. Mm-hmm. Because at first, they don't see what we're doing. Right. They're trusting me. But there's we were doing that whale piece in Bondi Beach, and we had an Aboriginal elder who was digging all 2,000 people going around. But there was a moment where they were side talking, chatting, and then all of a sudden, they became one giant whale. And it was like, and I've experienced that many times, but that one was very pronounced. And when you have that moment where it's possible for us to transcend our individual egos and then you see it manifest in physical form in that way, it's incredibly powerful. And then of course, the visuals become tools for advocating for the issues and things like that. But on a spiritual level, in the moment with the crowd, that is a moment that I'm always looking forward to.
Hmm. I think we all can kind of imagine it, although obviously experiencing it is about 100 times better than imagining it. And what a wonderful experience for those who have it to remember that we are one. You know, to in that moment, they go from the illusion of separation, where most of us live most of the time, into the divine remembrance of our unified field, our unified consciousness, our oneness. And that can be a life-changing experience for someone. That could be an oceanic experience that people remember for an instant. Oh, wow.
Mm. Wow. Mm. Mm. Beautifully said. Mm.
Yeah. John, thank you so much. It's an honor to meet you. Really just thank you so much for the good work you're doing. And we will continue to track what you're doing. And I hope you'll come on our show again. And once we start doing retreats, let's do a global peace tribe, something with you, okay?
Okay, that sounds good.
Good. God bless. Oh, and I didn't go to your website. I'm a little starstruck right now, to be honest. So John's website is artistsforamazonia.org, artistsforamazonia.org. And when people go there, John, any place you want to direct people?
Well, you could click on the link for the Amazon Climate Platform, which is something we developed for how politically what can help. And, you know, that has the rationale. And there's also a video of a live stream that we did, a 3.5-hour live stream that we did for COVID relief in the Amazon that has a lot of favorite artists and indigenous leaders that I think is a very compelling experience. You could just scan through it, but it has major artists, everyone from Barbra Streisand to Sting to Carlos Santana and Jeff Bridges and Ricky Martin and a lot of Latin artists. And so you can see the
list. Oh my heavens. Wow.
So that, you know, if you want to, even though it's focused on COVID and we did this 2 years ago, you also will learn a lot about just the basic reality of what it is to be an indigenous forest defender in the Amazon. And there, as someone said earlier, I think it was Sylvia in the pre-show, talking about the murder rates of indigenous forest defenders. And it is, we need to defend the defenders. I mean, these are the people who are putting their lives on the line every day to keep that forest standing, which affects all of our lives. It's not somewhere over there, it's all of our lives. So, you know, I would just suggest people kind of up-level their knowledge of it all and look for ways when they can to get involved, either through our website or, as I said, amazonwatch.org, which is our sister organization that does a lot of the advocacy directly. Mm-hmm. But it's an all hands on deck situation right now. And I think there is no climate solution without keeping the Amazon standing, basically.
Thank you so much. It's absolutely true. One of the most meaningful moments of my life was I spent 10 days in the Amazon with a woman named Roxanne Kramer, who protects pink river dolphins. And we had done some fundraising for her. And so we went and visited her, and that's what she does. She hires people, and it's a battle. It's a war between the poachers that kill pink river dolphins for their eyeballs, because their eyeballs are a delicacy in Japan. Imagine killing a beautiful creature like that for their eyeballs. And so she, you know, is at war with these poachers. It's incredible what the battle that's going on. Anyway, thank you so much, John. We've got a few announcements, and so I'm going to actually break them up into a couple of things. I want to acknowledge many of you, of course, know Jay Mayer. He's the creator of Light Touch and has been a wonderful sponsor and supporter of Saturday Night Live. And he has a new kind of a movement that he's really supporting, which is visualizing that it's 8 p.m., and the idea is to send as many blessings as possible, visualizing 8 p.m. Let me see. I saw him in the chat. Jay, are you available to briefly talk about this?
Sure.
Great. What are you up to, partner?
Well, you know, everyone prays, you know, everyone that I know prays, and all the religions pray, and, you know, but somehow we need to come together. And I'm so excited, really, to have a global peace tribe, because I think this is really kind of our thing, where, you know, when we take all that energy with Jews and Muslims and Christians and believers and non-believers and everyone, ideally we get everyone in the whole world, as many people as we can, to just focus on 8 o'clock in the evening. It's an infinity sign. So when we go, you know, thank you for helping Ukraine, you just imagine it's 8 o'clock, and then all of a sudden you're joining with, you know, however many thousands of people. It can happen so quickly, you know, with the Global Peace Tribe, and, you know, poster, you know, copy and pasting, you know, the flyer around, letting people come to the websites. So, you know, whatever works, you know, I've just held the vision for a long, long time that when we all focus together, you know, I'm talking to TM, for instance, you know, Inner Circles of Unity Church with Reverend Tim, and everyone loves the idea and they acknowledge it. And yeah, well, they've been doing that for a long time, but we haven't done it together. You know, we haven't gotten the Jews and the Christians and the Muslims and, you know, the believers and the armies. I think the army should be praying too,
right?
Politicians. So I think
just to be clear, so I understand, it's not that we have to pray at 8 p.m. at night, but whenever we're praying, we're tapping into the collective, so that kind of recognizing that on one level there is no time. So the collective is gathering at that 8 p.m. Is that the idea?
Yeah, you said it really well. I wrote that down, tapping into the collective.
Right.
Because, you know, it's just so much more than isolated groups.
Right.
It's kind of like NATO. You know, NATO is this collection of countries. We need to be a collection of faiths.
Beautiful. And all right. So everybody, let's all at least once a day, when we're doing our prayer, when we're doing our visualizing, specifically sending your prayer for peace into the collective. And I guess we'll kind of say that the dream basket, the address that we're sending our collective prayers to is 8 p.m. That's going to be our address. And Jay, thank you so much for being with us, as always. Thank you for all that you do to make the world a better place. God blessings. Thank you.
Yeah, great show, by the way. Really.
Thank you, Jay.
Great
thank
people, you know, meaningful conversations. Timely.
Thank you. And there's more, including Jay's beloved. We are going to, I'm spotlighting the wrong thing. I want to spotlight this. So tonight, we got a really special after show. And it's going to be the reading of this play that, or screenplay, I should say, that Robin wrote, called Getting Back to Jane. And all those little faces you see are people that are part of the reading, including the lovely and beautiful and talented Jan Kaplan, one of our senior producers. She's in it. I'm involved. Catherine Woodward Thomas, Robin. It's really, really a really fun show. Now, it's a whole screenplay. We're only doing a couple of scenes from the screenplay, but definitely join us for that tonight. I'll have more Global Peace Tribe announcements a little bit later, but I wanted to make sure that we got that in. All right, what's next? What's next is Brick Medicine Eagle. How perfect that I just had Jay on. I want to acknowledge that Brick Medicine Eagle comes to us via Jan Kaplan. Jan arranged for Brick to be with us. I know that Brick has been on Jay's after shows before. She's been on Saturday Night Live before. And Brick, I'm so grateful that you're able to join us tonight. And question for you, what does Earth Day 2022 mean to you? What would you like to share with us tonight?
Well, I'm honored to be here. What a wonderful group of people. I always love to come on, and I learned so much, and my heart's lifted so much by listening to all the other folks. And, you know, when I think of Earth Day, I think about the fact that I've been in love with the earth since I can remember. You know, I was raised in the backcountry of the Crow Reservation as a child on my dad's original Indian allotment. And we were just wild in the hills, you know, riding horseback and all of that. And I really fell so much in love with the earth. Sometimes the people were a little crazy. So I actually learned to love the earth more than anything, more than anyone, more than people even. And, you know, over time then I've come to consider that I work for her and for the family, the whole family of life. And certainly working with our human family is how we're addressing the issues right now. And, you know, as I've matured and evolved, I've really tuned in to my background in the sense of touching in with White Buffalo Woman. White Buffalo Calf Pipe Woman is the one who brought the sacred chinupa, you know, the sacred pipe that we all have heard about and many of us use for prayers. And the interesting thing about what she offers us is the understanding that we are in fact one with everything. She says, whatever you do to anyone, any being, anything in the whole circle of life, you do to yourself, for you are in fact one. And she doesn't say you're one family, one group, one anything. She means you are one being. And what's kind of fascinating is that modern science now, modern physics, is saying the same thing. I tease the physicists and say, oh, you caught up with White Buffalo Woman. She talked about that 20 generations ago. So for me, the thing that's really important for us right now is that sense of connection and seeing if we can find a way to drop into that larger, you know, it's like dropping our forebrain, our little regular human mind can't quite grasp that. It's just kind of way out there and too big. But that's when I think our shamanic mind comes into play, that deeper brain, the old brain and the intelligence that connects with everything. And when we can find that place of, you know, often we find it in meditation. I remember finding it standing on the edge of the Grand Canyon one time, just like all of a sudden it's like this incredible transformative bliss that says, I am in fact one with all of this. And that is so empowering, I think. And that some of my teachers say that that bliss, that feeling, that transformative feeling is literally the baseline of transformation for our earth. You know, it is the baseline source and upliftment that allows us to walk forward in whatever we do and make it really count. And, you know, I think of us human beings as we're standing on a tree, and we often think of ourselves as we're right up here at the top. And okay, we are at a certain level, we are at the top of that tree of life. And yet what we forget again and again and again and again and again is that all that's under us supports us, uplifts us, and is absolutely vitally necessary. So to come into that understanding and that connection, you know, that sense of love and connection with everything, right down to the very insects, which interestingly enough, we are killing, you know, we have destroyed almost 50% of them in many places, 75 and others. And they're down at the baseline. We knock that baseline out and we're gone. So we're playing with, unfortunately, and you know, we humans like to play right on the edge, I think. And we're playing with our own extinction. You know, so what's being asked of us by Mother Earth is to actually become mature, full human beings who love and care and steward and are part of life. And, you know, there are a couple things that I think are important. We're being asked to step up, and certainly physical action, you know, doing something in the real world. I love what Catherine was saying in so many ways. But, you know, I suggest to people decide to not do something. In other words, don't use those dryer sheets that have neocotinoids that kill the bees. Don't use Roundup and the sprays that harm things. And then on the other side, choose to do something. Grow a garden, walk barefoot. Like the little church that I go to as a community here in where I live, we're looking at adopting a family from the Ukraine. So it's like, what is it that you can do actually here in the world do? And that feels so important. And also, and I think sometimes we forget this, is the more shamanic spiritual action, where we really step out of the kind of push and shove and do that's the more masculine side of ourselves. And we drop into what I would think of as a more feminine, unified, connected kind of place where we come together. And I think that's where really deep transformation takes place. And that coming together can be a coming together to do shamanic practice. For me, White Buffalo Woman has asked me to create an online ceremonial membership where we can gather together, where we have an international group of people who learn about the ceremony and then do it. And a part of that is that I know we're all really busy. We've got so much going on. And so I'm willing to step up and create something that people can tune into, and we can do something deep and powerful and meaningful and rich and sweet and good in a brief time, so that we can really do that kind of action. And a thing I want to remind all of you about is that, you know, there are all kinds of action we can take, but as White Buffalo Woman reminds us, we're connected with absolutely everything all the time. There's never any disconnect. We are one being that communicates, communes, connects all along. So one of the things I'd remind you about is, in a sense, every thought, every action, every mood, everything you do is a prayer. Everything touches everything else. And so to find more and more the ability to, you know, we're all grouchy. It's like, yeah, I'm grouchy. And how would I like to be? What would I like to offer? How can I find that loving heart? How can I remember my connection with everything in such a way that I can really offer into the circle of life that which will uplift it and enliven it and support it and love it? And I know everyone else has been talking about this oneness and this love and this connection and really stepping up into our highest and finest selves now. It's incumbent upon us, our lives depend on it, the lives of all this family, beautiful family of life around us depend on it. So I'd like to sing a song. Do I have time to do that, Scott?
Would love for you to sing a song. I was actually, it was funny because I was going to say, I think she's going to sing a song. Is it okay if I remind her that she's going to do that? So it's a big yes.
All right. Well, I'm going to sing a song that is one I'm not so familiar with, but I really felt like tonight this would be the wonderful song to sing. It was written by a wonderful gal named Susan Savelle. She called it Vigil. And it's really a reminder. She wrote this maybe 20 years ago, and I wish that we might have been able to pay attention to this kind of thing in all these 20 years. But here's an invitation again for the kind of vigil that we might want to have. And I'm going to have a sip of water before I do this. If you give me all your dreams, I'll give you all of mine. Too many dreamers are sleeping, and we're running out of time. But if you give me all your hope, I'll give you all of mine. If we pray together, we'll make it through these times. And if you give me all your peace, I'll give you all of mine. If we help each other, we can disarm ourselves in time. But if you give me all your voice, I'll give you all of mine. We can sing together, knowing we can change these troubled times. And if you give me all your love, I'll give you all of mine. will create beauty and joy and abundant life this time. If you surrender all your force, comes power in return. Act and flow with mother and father in their turn. So if you share visions of peace, I'll add in some of mine. We'll create a tapestry, a weaving of peace in time. And may it be so.
Brooke, thank you so much. And I want to thank you not only for tonight, but for a lifetime of contributing. And I've seen you at way back Health and Harmony festivals, and you always have such a glow of love and such a love of the earth, and somewhere between a tolerance and a love of humanity. But you always do it with a lot of love, and I really appreciate that. And I do want to encourage people to go to actually two of her websites. This is Brooke Medicine Eagle's main site. So again, always put in your email address, get on the mailing list, so you know she can stay in touch with you. And we are Earth Keepers, and joining her membership program is a wonderful thing to do. So her website is medicineeagle.com. There's two E's, by the way, in there. Medicine ending with an E, eagle starting with an E. So there's two E's, medicineeagle.com. And yes, we are Earth Keepers, and we need to be part of the Earth Keeper program. So, you know, go into her Earth Keeper program and join. And that's a wonderful way to support her and to support the earth. I also want to encourage people to go to her Patreon. As those of you that are regulars know by now, I really believe in supporting our artists and our activists through Patreon. It's how I support a lot of people. And I'm going to join and start supporting Brooke tonight. And you can choose a membership level. And what's really, really nice, I'm going to come in at this level, is that this way our artists and our activists know that they can count on a certain amount of income coming in every month. We don't live in a culture that supports us. Oh, I've got to go into my own Patreon account because I already have one. So I will do that during the next song or the next break. So please join her Patreon, support Brooke Medicine Eagle. And Brooke, thank you for being you. Thank you so much.
Well, thanks for all of this. I'm just joyous at the coming together and the beauty and the offering and the sweetness and all of this goodness that we humans create. May we create even more. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. My pleasure. And I hope to see you again on our show again soon.
All right. You bet.
So, we're going to play a video next, and it's, you know, Barry, after tonight with all these amazing presenters, but I got to say, Claire Dubois, who you're about to see, is one of my favorite voices on the planet, and I think you'll see why in a moment. If you've heard her before, stick around and drop in again, because her message is so powerful and expressed with so much passion. She's the founder of Tree Sisters, I'm not going to say anything else. I just want you to drop into what Claire has to say.
This is not a simple time to be alive, you know, and I can talk about trees till the cows come home, and they are my greatest love, along with the rest of the planet, frankly. But actually what I really want to talk about is us. It's what it means to be human. is the conundrum that we find ourselves in, or the cauldron of alchemical potential that we find ourselves in, the reality that is what we have, whether you believe in it or not, I believe, chosen to be birthed into, chosen to be here for. And if you believe that you choose your time of birth, if you believe that we get to have some choice in that, then you might also believe that there would be a reason that you have chosen to be here at what is probably the greatest turning point for humanity, where we get to crash or we get to leap. It's going to be one or the other. And we don't know. If you know the science, it looks like we're going to crash. If you really understand that we have no idea what a human being actually is, then there's a distinct possibility that we could leap. If you don't believe that we were, that, you know, that you get to choose your point of birth, then, well, you're here anyway. So what are you going to do with it? So to me, there is just, there's one choice right now, and that is to turn into the skid, to turn into everything that's coming, or to turn your back on it and to miss the greatest opportunity for shared evolution that we've ever offered ourselves. And, you know, I think probably everybody else here has decided to do the turn into the skid version of events, because let's face it, turning your back to this is not empowering. It's not empowering. It's destabilizing, it's frightening, it's like an abdication of responsibility. You know, if there's a tsunami bearing down on you, don't you want to see? Don't you want to know what's coming? Don't you want to have some sense of capacity to take some action? And more than that, more than just taking action, don't you want to discover who you are? You know, don't we all want to know who we are, what we're made of? Don't we want to have the most meaningful incarnations we could possibly give it? You know, you hear people talk about, oh, there's souls queuing up to get onto planet Earth. You know, this is where it's all happening. And meanwhile, we've got so many people here going, oh my God, I just want to get off the planet. You know, I don't want to be here. I want to be as far, you know, like, let's see how many incredibly wealthy people are trying to figure out how to trash this planet and then get onto another one. Like, God damn it. This planet of ours is so miraculously, extraordinarily beautiful. And we're part of that. You know, it's very easy to forget that we're made of the same rain that has been raining in this world for hundreds of thousands of millions of years. You know, the water that is in your veins was in the dinosaurs, you know, has passed through God knows how many trees, been rained and rivered and rained and rivered and rained and rivered. And now it's in the river of you, you know. We aren't separate from this planet. We're made of this planet. It's just we happen to also be made of stardust. We happen also to be made of sunlight. We happen also to be made with a cosmic breath of some description that is part of all that is. You know, in this moment, you are being kissed all over by a sky that has no limit, but vast intelligence. So then what's the possibility of humanity? A limitless cosmos worth of intelligence is available for this little bit of planet that's walking around trying to wake up to who or what it is. You know, is the cosmos and the sky going to just go out on shopping? Is that the game we're playing? Do we think that limitless intelligence merged with Gaia and her absolute magnificence is just going to throw herself away because she can't be bothered to wake up to the miracle of life? You know? We're doing a really good rendition of that, but I just don't buy it, because I think inside every one of us is extraordinariness waiting for us to realize that that's what's here. And it's frightening. It's frightening because we've been taught that we're less than, we've been taught to give our power away, we've been taught that we're not sovereign, we've been taught that a culture that is wiping out its own life support machine is a sane culture, and it's not. So we're living in an insane mindset that has created fundamental separation from all that is, and we're being told that that's normal. And any form of breaking out of what is normal feels incredibly weird in your body, because we've been cultured and conditioned to a certain way of being, but that way that we've been conditioned is fractured. It's a lie. We're not here to destroy ourselves. We're here to love ourselves and each other into the fullest expression of what a human being is. And we have no idea what that even means. And that's why I've got hope. There are Indigenous people on this planet who know how to put crystal in the ground and create water, who know how to work with the weather, who know how to go to Fukushima and do prayer and reduce radioactivity. They are much closer to understanding what a human being is because they are in dynamic relationship with nature, which is their nature. Human nature is nature. And if we log on to nature rather than just logging on to the bloody internet, we can log on to the real internet, which is actual creation, then we will find that we have no edges. There is nowhere where you end and nature begins, because there's only one being here, and it is a being full of light and intelligence. And if we can open our minds and our bodies and our nervous systems enough, with enough humility, to let life as it really is pour in, till we're on our knees in humility before the miraculousness of creation, then you get to be broken open through the conundrum that we have created for ourselves. Broken open through fear and shock and all the rest of the stuff that you naturally feel when you feel powerless and when a tsunami is breaking on you. But then if you can open your arms and say, do me, come on. We've created this. We've created this for our own evolution. Then what are we going to do? Pretend it's not happening? Or are we going to let it rip us open beyond all the limitations that are nothing to do with who we are, so that we can find that immensity, that love, that meaning, that passion, that grief, that rage, that ecstatic nature that is nature? You don't see a tree going, oh, I'm so sorry, I'm so beautiful. Oh, I'm just going to strip. Oh, I'm too much. Oh, I'm too little. You know, nature doesn't do this weird thing that we do with ourselves. It just gives itself completely. That to me is the moment that we have created for ourselves. We've created a moment of absolute radical possibility for ourselves, where if we're willing to fully feel and fully face everything that we have created for ourselves, these are the circumstances for our own transcendence. Because we are life, and life wants us to wake up. Because we are nature, and nature is not here to self-combust. Because we are extraordinary potential. We are a living cosmos inhabited in this little bit of Gaia, which is billions of years worth of wisdom and experience and experimentation. And here's humanity standing there, sky meeting earth, with all of that inside us and in our so-called junk DNA, the DNA of every living species on this planet. We are a walking activation of nature consciousness waiting to happen. So I believe I had 7 minutes, and that's probably it. So I'll just end by saying, what are we here for? If you incarnated right now, whether you think it was a choice or not, you're here for the greatest turning this species is ever going to have, probably. Either for profound waking up or the deepest level of regret we could possibly imagine when we say, sorry, guys, to our children, go face a child. Say, sorry, I just couldn't be bothered to try. I didn't want to know who I actually was. I threw in the towel when it all looked too difficult. Or you just go, hell yes, bring it on. Here we are. This is what I've created for myself. This is what I want. I want to wake up. I want to know who I am. I want to know what's possible. I want to know what everybody is capable of through radical shared responsibility and humility before the magnificence of what a human being is, which we can discover if we're willing to drop what we've been taught we are, because it's nothing to do with what a human being actually is. This is not us. And there we have it. Mwah.
Boom. Just Claire expresses herself with such incredible passion. And isn't that like listening to, I'm going to use the word God, talking to us? I mean, it's such a clear expression of wisdom and passionate understanding. Yeah, obviously I'm a big fan of Brooke Medicine Eagle, and I'm a big fan of Claire Dubois. And what an honor to hear from both of them tonight. And Sean Quigley, actually, everybody. All right. If you want to support Claire, her organization is Tree Sisters. I donate, to be honest, $125 every month to Tree Sisters. They do phenomenal work. It's really powerful. And so it's simple. Just go to treesisters.org, learn about what they're doing, and support. That is how we can support Claire Dubois and her wonderful work. I knew it was going to be tough to follow Brooke and to follow Claire, but fortunately we have Tatiana Speed with us. And Tatiana is not only a beautiful musical artist, but she creates beautiful videos. She'll record one of her songs, and then she'll find images to go along with it. And so, Tatiana, thank you for being with us. Please tell us about the Earth music video that we're about to see.
Sure. First of all, whoa, I feel like I just got blasted in my seat by that. That was unbelievable. Yeah. You know, both you, Brooke, and that speech, I mean, I just, there's nothing, that was everything. Everything was there. Literally everything. So yeah, maybe this song can just speak to this moment, to what we've just heard. The song is called Earth Family, and the first line is, "Today we come together with a new vision for humanity." And I feel like that vision has just been shared so beautifully, eloquently, heartfully, and this video can just support what has already been spoken. So thank you, Scott.
Oh, thank you. I'm so glad we have it to show. Thank you.
Today we come together with a new vision for humanity to co-create a united Earth family. And with this vision and our shared intuition, we have the potential to bring peace on Earth to fruition. We imagine a world where we take care of all of life. And with this intention, we become beacons of light. So let's join together in manifestation to bring about societal transformation. From the heart of humanity, we come together in unity to co-create a united Earth family. From the heart of humanity, we come together in unity to co-create a united Earth family. We come together to unite, we come together to ignite unity. Between all forms of life, I see the one in the all and the all in the one. Our hearts beat to the same drum. We come together for the fate of the earth. Every single one of us is needed to rebirth. A new community, a new earth family, a new reality and unity for all humanity. If we educate, we can innovate, create a blank slate for the world to co-create a new fate of societal change and renewal. Indigenous knowledge is a key, is a tool. From the heart of humanity, we come together in unity to co-create a united Earth family. From the heart of humanity, we come together in unity to co-create a united Earth family. United, let's come together, Earth family.
innovators. We are change makers, pioneers, and trailblazers, paving a path for an inclusive civilization to arise, a regenerative future for all beings, all life. We nurture cultures of peace and integrity. We celebrate the beauty of our infinite diversity, and from every corner of the world, creative expression paves the way for a future of intimate connection. The leaders of today, the leaders of tomorrow, we have seeds to sow, visions to grow, places to go, and now we know it's time for unity to co-create a united Earth family. From the heart of humanity, we come together in unity to co-create a united Earth family. From the heart of humanity, we come together in unity to co-create.
I'm going to bring Brooke on because I can see her. And I think, again, here are two generations, and you both are delivering the same message in your own unique ways. Wasn't that video beautiful, Brooke? And Brooke, you muted.
I'm sorry, what did you ask? I was enjoying so much, I wasn't listening.
No, I just said, I was just asking you, I saw your enthusiasm, and so I'm spontaneously bringing you on at the same time, because I think that both you and Tatiana were saying the same thing in your own unique ways. And so that's why I'm spontaneously bringing you on with Tatiana.
And the music is so magical. I just really appreciate it. Thank you so much, Tatiana, and all of you who bring music into our lives. It's just the best.
Oh, thank you, Brooke. That means so much coming from you, because you are just an unbelievable human being on this earth. So thank you for saying that. And it's just an honor to meet you, honestly. So thank you.
Stay connected.
It's kind of sweet to see. I love bringing people together. And so to see Tatiana and Brooke together in this moment, both sharing the same message in their own unique and beautiful way, is really powerful. And again, a reminder, you can support Tatiana by going to tatianaspeed.com. Definitely make sure you follow her on Instagram. And Tatiana, you've become such an incredibly important part of the Global Peace Tribe. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Scott, so much. Thank you.
Wow, all right. Big thanks to Jay and Jan, who created that video and chose that song. It was a powerful song, and I thought it was just so perfect for tonight and what we're doing. I want to really invite everybody to make sure you join us again tomorrow morning. Don't worry, we've still got a lot of show left, but now that it's the Global Peace Tribe announcements, I get to make the announcements. And one of them is to make sure you join us tomorrow morning for our Sacred Sunday show. Again, The Awakening World is always three shows over the course of the weekend, a Friday night, a Saturday night, and a Sunday morning. And tomorrow, Robin has invited some wonderful guests. She invited Dan Lalia, who I've experienced Dan Lalia's visualizations, and they're very, very powerful, very extraordinary. And Anna Maria Vasquez, I saw her on a World Unity Week show, invited her to join us. She's just written a book that's very relevant. And then this wonderful man, Zaya Loudon, very impressed with who he is. And he's a beautiful, beautiful speaker. So we've got a wonderful show tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock Pacific time, 1 o'clock Eastern. Please make sure that you join us. And again, a reminder that our after show is going to be very unique tonight. We are going to have some music. We are going to have that, but we also have a beautiful poetry reading. But really, the main focus of the after show is going to be this script reading of Getting Back to Jane, an environmental screenplay. So definitely make sure you stick around for that. I also want to invite you to support the Global Peace Tribe. And there's a couple of ways you can do it. There's a really, really quick and easy way to do it, which is for anybody who shops through Amazon, please join the Amazon Smile program and choose Unify the World as the organization that you're sponsoring. And actually, when you're doing that, you're supporting us, the Global Peace Tribe, and it adds up. We get, I think it's half a cent for every dollar spent, and a lot of us, I know I'm constantly ordering from Amazon. My roommate who just walked into the kitchen calls it the magic deck. All of a sudden, just boxes keep showing up on the magic deck. And now 1/200th of the money spent on Amazon is coming back to Global Peace Tribe. So please join the Amazon Smile program. I also want to encourage you to support us. And thank you for those of you who registered and created a donation when you registered. I really appreciate that. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And if you feel like you're really enjoying what we're doing and you want to see it continue, your donation is really helpful. And you can join, or you can support us by going to supportgpt.com. Supportgpt.com, or take your trusty phone, put it on camera, and then just take the camera towards the Q code and the way to donate will pop up. And then you can just use your phone and donate right now. And I really appreciate people's donations. It means a lot to us. And to be honest, we need it. We need more support. Right now, it's pretty much me and Debbie Johnston keeping everything moving, having the Awakening World come to you. We do support a lot of artists. And it's really important to get your support. So thank you very much for that. All right. So I also want to thank one more time. Where is she? Where's Robin? I want to bring Robin on for a minute. Where are you, Robin? Ah, there you are. You had your camera off. Thank you again. Let's all take a moment to twinkle Robin. She is who invited most of the guests that you've seen. And she's done a really, really wonderful job. So thank you very, very, very much, Robin, for everything you've done tonight. And anything you'd like to add before we go into kind of our final prayer with grandmother?
I just want to add that the feeling tonight is one of great hope. And I know all of us will go out and embrace the earth and, draw in all its gifts and in the moment. And that's sort of what the screenplay is about later. So I hope you all stay. It's going to be really fun, the after show. So thank you.
Beautiful. All right. Well, thank you, Robin. And we're in the home stretch of the main show. So Grandmother Flor de Mayo is one of our most sacred elders. She's been on our show a few times now, and I had the honor of doing a pre-show or a pre-record with her, and we'd asked her if she would do a prayer for Earth Day. And it was one of those things. I was getting my car serviced an hour and a half away, and I'm driving like mad to get home just in time for my pre-recorded with grandmother. It was scheduled for 2 p.m., and I literally walked through my door at 5 minutes till 2 o'clock, got to my computer right here just in time to pre-record with her. And she said, "Scott, Spirit told me I want you to pray with me." And I was like, "Really?" And she said, "Yes, I want you to pray with me." So I start the prayer. She asked me to start it, and then she completes it. It wasn't what I had imagined, so bear with my part of it. And her prayer is very powerful. And so let's take what we've heard from Brooke Medicine Eagle, the music from Tatiana and Destiny, the powerful message from Claire and John, and at the beginning, our Pacha Video people. And let's integrate that as we really drop into this prayer. Taking some deep breaths together at our own pace. Bringing our attention inside into ourself. And with every breath, gratitude for breath, gratitude for life. Bless us that we may become clear channels for Spirit to flow through. We give thanks for this opportunity to commune together. I am honored to pray with Grandmother. And may we all open our hearts, open our minds, and as the breath of life comes through, recommit to being clear vessels for the one eternal beloved, Holy Spirit, that which has a thousand names, to flow through us and to live life as powerfully as it wants to through each of our unique vessels.
Beloved Creator, beloved Beauty, beloved Light of this sacred moment, Mother, Father, Creator of all things. We are here in a sacred circle, beloved Beauty, honoring the spirit of our beloved mother. Our beloved mother, who is the creator of all. This beautiful, beautiful planet, beloved creator. We call the earth. This beautiful, beautiful, moving, breathing earth, beloved beauty. For millennia, beloved creator, we have been walking on Mother Earth, enjoying all of the goods that she has given us for food, for medicine, the richness of all of the beautiful greenery, beloved creator. We have made journeys for eons around the globe. All of us, each and every one of us, have moved about throughout the earth. in the mist and in the joy of all that lives on the earth, beloved Creator. All of the animals, the big, big animals, beloved Creator, that live on the earth, till the little, teeny, teeny, weeny ones. All of those that crawl, all of those that fly, all of those that live on the trees, beloved beauty. You have brought us together to be a family, to help each and each other. But you had also given us the wisdom to know the good and to know the indifferent. You've given us the heart for us to guide ourselves so that we take everything into consideration, that all of life, no matter how big, no matter how small, we are here because of our beloved Mother Earth. It is a day in which we recognize that the earth needs to be honored. Beloved beauty, I ask of you, why isn't it that we celebrate every day of our lives, to give gratitude for our lives, all that exists on the earth, our food, our medicine, our breath, our sacred breath, the sacred waters, beloved beauty, the spirit of the fire, the sun shining upon us, beloved Creator. Remind us that we should honor and celebrate each and every day should be Earth Day. This is the beauty that we should honor. To do ceremony, to do gratitude, of do prayers, and to be in pure joy of all of the beauty that is around us. To remind ourselves not to be destructive. To remind ourselves that in a lifetime, we cannot destroy the earth. Not only the earth, but all of life. The air, the water, beloved Creator, touch us. Open our hearts. Expand our hearts, beloved beauty. So that we can come together in a circle of prayer each and every day and each and every night, and do the best that we can to preserve. We have a chance at this very moment to make it possible for the future generations. I'm sending prayers. I'm planting a seed in everyone's heart that the destruction has to stop. The neglect has to stop. The abuse has to stop. Because if we do not stop, we do not have a future. It's imperative at this very, very moment that we make a conscious decision of doing the right thing for all of life, all that breathes, all that is nurtured by the water, and all that grows by the light of the sun. Beloved Creator, on this sacred day, I call upon each and every one, brothers and sisters of the Four Direction, to come together, to hold hands with your family, your children, your friends, your lovers, your husband, your wives, your neighbors, your community, your town, your country. Beloved Creator, let us all come together, put our prayers together for the good of life. Beloved beauty, on this sacred day, let us make a commitment. Let us make a sacred vow that we will protect and honor all of life on this earth. We are all a family. Beloved Creator, let it be so. In the name of the spirit of all of our ancestors, in the name of all of our ancestors, of all of the sacred lands around the earth, all of the waters, beloved beauty, all of the forests, in the name of the four sacred elements of life, the air, the water, the fire, beloved Creator, on this sacred day, the earth, beloved beauty. In the name of all of the beauty around us, in the name of the great mystery, beloved Creator, I thank you. And I thank each and every one of you for being here at this sacred, sacred moment. Much love and light to each and every one of you. Thank you.
I'd like to encourage everyone to go to Grandmother Flora DeMaio's, her website, and definitely please put in your name and how to contact you so that you can stay in touch with what she's doing. And what she's doing is always so important, so please, please do that. And her website is grandmotherfloradeMaio.com. GrandmotherFloraDeMaio.com. Debbie, I know, has put that into the chat box for all of you. We kind of take all this incredible, passionate information that we've heard, this beautiful music that we've heard from people of all ages tonight. And there's something else that Robin found that's kind of fun. Robin, I'm going to bring you on. Do you want to talk a little bit about the Bird Talker video? Would you like to introduce that?
I just unmuted. Hi. Yeah. It's just actually a discovery that a friend sent me and just said, you know, I think you'll love this video. And then I said, Scott has to see this video. And that's about it. It just kind of blew us both away. And let's see it. Enjoy.
Okay. Okay, great. Here we go.
I've played the teacher, the preacher, guru, maintaining posture, separating me and you, as if the thoughts of God were mine and mine to speak. I've listened with an agenda so I could prove all of the shit I believe to be true, just to hide the fear of being weak. Burn the scorecards, balance out the scales. We are one when distracted by our differences. Underneath what's detectable with eyes, every particle's vibrating with the same light. How can we all belong when all our logic is colliding and it's constantly dividing me from you? So damn those eager protestations on your tongue. Shut your brain up long enough to hear the lowly hum. Underneath what's detectable with eyes, every particle's vibrating with the one life.
Finally agree, don't mean a thing.
Burn the scorecards, balance out the scales.
Land of the wrong.
We are one when distracted by our differences. Damn those eager protestations on your tongue. Shut your brain up long enough to hear the lowly hum. Underneath what's detectable with eyes, every particle is vibrating.
It's a really great video. That's really, really powerful. Thank you, Robin, for finding it. Thank you so much. All right. Amazing. We're bringing it in right on time. We're going to be done pretty close to 8:30 for the after show. And we're going to close with going back to Hawaii and back to our beloved Destiny Love. Destiny, thank you for being with us tonight. What a night.
Such an honor. Wow. So potent. I'm so grateful. Yeah. So grateful to receive and to be able to give my gifts of prayer and song to the earth and to spirit. Thank you.
Well, I'm grateful that you're going to conclude our main show. So take it away. Mm-hmm.
mountains can be moved, even oceans can be soothed, even the hardest stone can be grooved. Listen, listen to the wind. Listen, carries magic information. Now listen to the wind on your skin. Ooh. Let's go to the mountain. Let's go to the sea. Let's go move them boulders between you.
Destiny, I'm going to go to gallery view so we can see everybody twinkling you there for a moment.
Thank you so much. Yeah, may we remember all of the elemental support all around us, and that we're not alone in this journey. All it takes is that every day we have to show up at our altar, at our earth altar, giving thanks, touching the tree, touching the ground, dedicating our entire prayer to all my relations. I show up here every day to honor each element for not only myself and my marriage and my family, my tiny little microcosm. May I be kind here and may that ripple out. And may we know that these simple things are so impactful. Showing up, connecting with the earth in your environment and praying that you're in a good way, that all of your actions are in a good way. And the ones that aren't, change them because it's time. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Destiny. Thank you so much for who you are and how you're showing up in our world and for being such a beautiful inspiration. And one more time, just a reminder, everybody, to go to her link tree. It's linktrw.ee/destinylovemusic. And imagine how wonderful it would be to take voice healing work with her. You know, with her passionate understanding of humanity, to embody your voice. So definitely, if you're interested, you can, of course, listen to some of her beautiful, beautiful music here. But you can also talk to her about getting private coaching from Destiny. Mm-hmm. And so I think that's a beautiful offering that you provide among so many things, Destiny. And give Andrew.
I love you so much.
Thank Andrew for taking care of the kiddos so you could be with us tonight. And big love to you and a big love to Andrew and the family.
Thank you so much for hosting this, Scott. And wow, what a powerful ripple this is having. Thank you. Love you.
Love you too. Talk to you soon. Well, that is our main show for the night. Again, please, everybody, stick around. I'm going to stop the recording of this and start the recording of the after show.